Hello, in this presentation I'm going to demonstrate a converter from Markdown files into Mathematica notebooks or Wolfram language notebooks. So we're going to follow this flowchart here. I'm going to show the command line interface to that converter, and we're going to find some question from Mathematica Stack Exchange and then convert, save it as a Markdown file, convert it to a notebook and do some comparisons. So the function is called from Markdown, and so this is the help which this, I mean basically, yeah, it takes either free text or it takes text files. Actually, let's do text first here. So if I do my section, right, this should convert it to a notebook, which is pretty boring. So let me do something something more more interesting. So we're going to do I'm going to use this Unix command to make my my Markdown here directly ad hoc, right? And so let's say it's my section here, and okay, some text and a formula. And the formulas informally, this is not in the specifications, this is in the extended Markdown. We use dollar sign to around formulas. All right, and let me do a code block. Mathematica understands Mathematica notebooks, they understand Python pretty well actually, so we're going to put to make this very typical Python type of cell. And where is it, right? And I can do UF. Actually, before doing this, I think I need to close the with the quote mark, and then I can do UF. All right. So this produced a notebook, notebook expression. And so here, if I open in Mathematica, if I open a new notebook, and I use the command, let me zoom this here, and I use the command notebook put, and this expression which was just we obtained, this is going to produce a notebook, right, which kind of sort of has something to do with what was typed in here. All right, well, yeah, whatever. Right, but this was you know, just kind of showing, but yeah, we can do text from the command line. Now let's actually do the more interesting and more useful part. It's like very often, like say Mathematica Stack Exchange, we might see some code we want to experiment with, but because the code is interlaced with explanations, it might be far from straightforward to make a notebook or experimental code with it. So I was looking recently into some ellipse detection in images, right? So multiple misspellings here. All right, and let's look into this. Yeah, let's take this code. I'm not going to edit it, of course. I'm just going to select the code. And so here in, I'm going to open a Markdown editor, right? And which is, you know, and corresponds to what we saw. I'm going to save it like say MSC example. All right, so here I'm going to convert this file which I just saved. I'm going to convert it to a notebook, right? Okay. And of course, it would be better if I save it. And let's see what is going to happen. And this, I opened the notebook, went to my other screen, so let me zoom a little, not much. And let's compare with this one. Well, actually, in order to compare, we need to evaluate with some kind of evaluation elements happening here. All right. And this seems to correspond to what this notebook is. When I convert images or links, so this is actually an important detail, kind of minor but kind of important. So let me move to the raw markdown. So image links in StackExchange were given as reference links at the bottom of the markdown. And you can see, like, say, these images were referenced in this way. Now, this kind of references, I convert them in this manner in Wolfram language. I use import and the link. So there's no point for me, for this notebook, to build up some association or something, right? Which it's essentially duplicates what this reference is. It's like there's some correspondence between the link labels and the actual links. I embed the links directly into the code, and since we don't know the images, these are just links, right? It does make sense to put import around them. And it seems that we're producing something very similar to what was given in this post. So I'll say this was a successful demo, so declare victory. So what we did, command line interface, chose, found some interesting questions from Mathematica StackExchange, saved it as a markdown file, converted it into a notebook, and did some comparison. All right, thank you for your attention. Bye.